Hi, I'm Filedescriptor. Today, I want to do another walkthrough of Intigriti's XSS challenge that I helped design. This challenge was only solved by 14 people, so you can say it's the hardest challenge yet. There's nothing special about the rules. We just need to pop an alert without user interaction in Firefox or Chrome, but again, no parameters given. So let's check out the source code. There's only one line of JavaScript, and all it does is make a post message call to the parent window. But this page isn't being framed. What's going on? It turns out the real challenge page is the initial loading screen. Here we see more JavaScript code. Let's go over how the code works. The entry point is the onload function. Once the page finishes loading, it calls the loadChallenge function with location hash as the parameter. If location hash is not set, then it changes location hash to June, which triggers the onHashChange function, which calls loadChallenge. In loadChallenge, it creates an iframe which loads a resource specified by the location hash. Finally, the fakeChallenge page in the iframe makes a postMessage call, which triggers the onMessage function. Then some checks are performed, and the challenge page will redirect to a URL specified by the postMessage call. In this process, we identified the location hash and postMessage source, as well as the location href sync. Normally, we analyze how each source goes to each sync, but we only have one sync here, so instead, we will work backwards. In order to reach the location href sync, we need to pass two checks. The first check makes sure the message sender is from the embedded iframe. If we try to frame the challenge page, then send a message to it. This check will reject the message because event source will point to window parent, which is not the iframe's window. At first glance, it looks like we need to use the loadChallenge function and find a page that either allows running custom JavaScript codes or leads to open redirect so that we can send a message from the iframe. But there's an easier way. When you frame a frame which frames another frame, you can change the URL of that frame. The location property is one of the very few properties that is writable across origin. So to bypass the first check, we just need to frame the challenge page, alter its iframe's location to a page we control, and send a message from there. The second check is an origin check involving the search method of string. This method acts like indexOf, except it takes regular expression as parameter. Basically, it checks if the sender's origin appears anywhere in this URL string. This weird string replacement is to prevent abusing the dot character as a wildcard in rejects, otherwise something like this URL could bypass the check. You may think, couldn't we just use something like tigriti.io to bypass the check if it's looking for a substring? Well, you can't really do that because an origin must start with the ULF scheme, so the substring is forced to start at the beginning. Is there any substring under this condition that resembles a valid origin and under our control? Yes, challenge-june.in is a valid top-level domain that anyone could have registered. In fact, someone bought this domain and submitted it as a solution. What if you're late to the party? Don't worry, there's another solution that anyone can try. We know that a domain name can only consist of alphanumeric characters plus a dash. But what about IP addresses? Not IP version 4, but IP version 6. An IP version 6 address starts and ends with square brackets, with the hash string separated by colon inside. If you are familiar with rejects, you'll know it matches a character inside any character in the square brackets. Let's say we have this IP version 6 address, it will match http://c, which makes the condition valid. So the solution looks like this. We host a server with an IP version 6 address which has the letter C in the address, then frame the challenge page, change its iframe location to our page, then send an XSS payload to the challenge page. Boom. If Safari was allowed in this challenge, we could even solve it by using a subdomain with a pipe character, since Safari allows certain symbols in the subdomain. That's it. I hope you can use this technique in your future bug hunting.
But Filedescriptor, who does URL validation like this? This is just a made-up challenge.
I'm glad you asked. I actually found this exact bug on Twitter and used it as an inspiration for this challenge. Check out the report in the description if you want to know more.